This game is actually really fun. Wait, did I accidentally make Karlson? If you watch game dev videos like you're playing Cookie Clicker like I do, chances are you've heard about a guy named Danny, or at the very least, seen one of his videos. He's that guy who loves milk and is always talking about how random stuff is thick.
Is it just me, or is that bone looking kinda thick?
Anyway, he's been working on this game called Karlson for like, I think forever, and I sort of accidentally may have started to make it. Let me explain. I hang out on the Unity Discord to try to offer help to other game devs where I can. Someone was asking for help on a slide mechanic, so being the good Samaritan that I am, I was trying to help them. Like I was saying, I decided to take the high road and didn't say anything in response. Instead, in spite, I decided to make an entire character controller from scratch with a slide mechanic.
Who doesn't know how to use Unity now, Big Jared?
The slide was fun, but it felt like the game needed more. After watching a Bargy video while I was stuffing my face at lunch, I implemented a wall run mechanic. At first, it was a little tough to keep the wall run going. So I just made it incredibly easy. I have a tendency to make difficult game mechanics, so I was pretty surprised at the amount of fun I was having from an easier wall run. I felt like I was a scuffed Spider-Man or something.
Who are you?
My name is Jeff.
And I could really see how someone might easily gravitate towards a grapple mechanic because of this. As I was saying, at this point I was ready to show the game to someone, so I showed it to my wife, and her response was,
"It's neat, but it'd be cooler to see from a different perspective."
So I added in some wall running animations that no one will ever see unless you watch this video or this game ever becomes multiplayer, which it probably won't. Typically, the way that first person perspectives work are that the hands and weapons are drawn as a separate layer on top of everything. I originally started to do that, but liked seeing the character's belly when he looked down. So instead, I decided to throw the character model into Blender and just chop off their head. For the current player, both models are shown, but the headed one only renders shadows. With some added code for the camera that limits how far the player can look down, some vertical movement for crouching and sliding, and some tilt when a player is wall running, it works pretty well. And because I use the same bones and animator for both headed and headless models, they should always line up.
Bruh.
Since the game was completely bug-free at this point, I thought it was time for some polish. So I opened up Blender and got to painstakingly modeling all of the assets. Then I placed them into the scene to replace the placeholder objects that I had been using. I put a few hours in, and I did actually end up doing some modeling of my own. This is what the game looked like. As some final touches, I made start and finish lines as well as checkpoints along the way which player can slide through to activate. The finish line is blocked off by lasers until all checkpoints have been crossed. At the end, there's a big pile of cash that decreases the longer it takes you to complete the course. To add in a bit of risk reward, I also placed cash around the course you can pick up as well. And that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching, and if you want 7 years of good luck, make sure to like and subscribe. If this gets to 69,000 likes, I'll publish this game somewhere, or maybe if a couple of you just asked me to, whichever comes first.